Assalamu alaikum. Inshallah, you're well, guys. So alhamdulillah, it feels great to be back. For those of you who don't know, I've been out for about 2 months because my dad became really unwell in Pakistan and I had to fly out at short notice. And to be honest with you, I've had a bit of a tough time trying to get back because Pakistan was put on the red list. So I had to spend 10 days in hotel quarantine, which, to be honest with you, wasn't as bad as people have said. I know there's a lot of videos out there on YouTube about people being served haram food and the service not being that great. But to be honest with you, largely it was a positive experience. But at the end of the day, home is home. And honestly, it feels so good to be back. And inshallah, I'm looking forward to creating more content for you guys. So I wanted to start off by saying a big thank you to everyone, because whilst I was out in Pakistan, it was really motivating to see that people were still commenting, sending me messages on Instagram and watching my videos. And I also saw the number of subscribers increase as well, even though I hadn't posted any content. And inshallah, I'll continue to provide more useful content for you guys. So I was sat here thinking today, Fazan, you've been away for about 2 months. What can you talk about in your first video back? And I thought to myself, I get a lot of messages from people who are a bit nervous about joining the Big Four or a large organization because they've heard so much about negative experiences. The culture isn't right. It's very corporate. There's no work-life balance, limited career development. And honestly, having worked for about 4 large organizations in my career to date, I really do think that's unfair. I can safely say that in my own experience, I found that the positives largely outweigh the negatives. And honestly, I've had no major issues when working for a large organization. So I wanted to talk about positive experiences to help you guys and inshallah motivate you to continue applying and get the best job offers. So I thought there's no better place to start than what happened with my dad and how my company treated me. So it was towards the end of March where I got a phone call about my dad being unwell in Pakistan, very much an emergency. And we got the phone call extremely early in the morning. So it was around about 4 or 5 a.m. in the morning. And we obviously had to make a decision on what to do. And because of the emergency, we actually decided to fly out. And honestly, at that point, I had no issues or no doubts or any concerns that me taking leave suddenly is going to be an issue. In fact, when I rang my manager at about 7 a.m. in the morning, the call was literally a minute. I explained to him what happened and he said, "Fez, that's fine. When are you going to fly out?" I discussed that with him and he said, "That's absolutely fine. Just take your phone and laptop because you don't know how long you're going to be," which is fair in the circumstances. "And also let me know what I need to cover for you." That's it. There was no project or meeting that was seen as bigger than my dad's health or any meeting that I definitely had to make. It was literally drop everything and go and keep us up to date. I felt I would have been treated the same even with my previous employees. And for those of you who come from Pakistan, India, or developing country, you guys know how tough it is if you fall ill in that country. It's not like the UK where if you need a blood test, the nurses will come and grab you and they'll take you to the relevant area. You've got to go there yourself. And for me, there was a lot of running around. If you need to have a blood test, you need to pay for it first. You need to take the patient, in my instance, my dad, to that particular area where blood tests are performed. There's a lot of running around to do. And honestly, my team and my manager were absolutely fine with me taking as much time off as needed, especially at short notice. So it was pretty much a situation that was changing day by day, and I needed my team to be very flexible when it came to holiday and taking time off. And definitely there were no issues with that. I just had to let my manager know by text. And what was great to see was it wasn't just my manager that was being very supportive. It was my SVP as well. So for those of you who are hearing SVP for the first time, it stands for Senior Vice President. And this is a job title that's very, very common in American listed companies. And I'd say if you work in practice or looking to go into the Big Four top 10, it's the equivalent of a very senior director slash partner level role. So it is pretty much as high as you can get without being the president or the CEO of the company. I remember my SVP's exact words were, "Fez, don't worry. Family comes first, so take off all the time that you need and don't worry about meetings. We can pick that up in your absence." Remember, this was an emergency. So I still had meetings in place, projects going on, things that relied on my input and expertise, but I never once felt, "Oh, actually, I need to make this meeting," or "This meeting was bigger than a doctor's appointment regarding my dad's health." It wasn't like that at all. And it was great to see that that message was not only coming from my immediate manager, but from the most senior person in my department as well. And even when it came to remote working in Pakistan, it was extremely flexible. So even though we're a European-based team predominantly, we report into the US team at head office. And Pakistan is 4 hours ahead of the UK and 8 hours ahead of the US. And we always have meetings with our US colleagues. And if you think about it, US time, 1 p.m. is 5 p.m. UK time. And that means 9 p.m. Pakistan time. So quite late. And honestly, everyone in my department was very flexible, trying to flex their diaries where if there was a meeting that was quite late Pakistan time, they would cancel that and rearrange that when it's convenient for me. And that honestly helped so much because I was stuck in Pakistan during Ramadan. So when it was iftar time, maghrib time or any other salah time, it was great that I could flex my meetings, move things at short notice to prioritize Ramadan. And it wasn't just within my team, but across the business. Obviously, you guys know that working internal audit, you're seen as a business partner for lots of areas within finance, but outside finance as well. And honestly, I've spoken about how well I was supported by my team, but that same support was reciprocated around finance and other people I had meetings with. So people would see my background on team, see it's changed, be inquisitive, want to know where I am. They understood my situation, they showed empathy and were willing to flex as well because I had a lot of problems with Wi-Fi, so sometimes I'd get disconnected. So again, they'd rebook meetings. And you've got to remember, everyone has work to do. So they weren't only flexing to accommodate for my needs, but they also had to flex their diaries, their plans going forward as well, because the fact that this meeting was cancelled or delayed would impact their workload. It would mean that they would have to pick up something at a later date. And it was great to see that they were willing to do that for me. And whilst wrapping up this video, I want to come back to this point around empathy and people. Always remember that it's the people that work for an organization that define the culture. And for me, having worked for lots of organizations, I found that with larger organizations, they have a lot of diversity. They'll have lots of people working from different backgrounds, different situations, and that means that the workplace is more inclusive. So I don't really agree when people say, oh, it's a corporate culture, people aren't understanding, you may not like it, the work-life balance isn't there. And inshallah, in one of my future videos, I'm actually going to touch upon the work-life balance point and why I don't agree with that being a negative or a reason why you should avoid working for a Big Four or another similar sized organization. But inshallah, I'm going to leave it there for now, guys. For those of you who are new to the channel, please do hit that subscribe button. I really do appreciate the support you guys give.